Hello and welcome to another Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, you are going to learn about the tab application and how it can be used within your project. This type of application works as a container application, meaning that it can be used to display multiple applications at once. It can be very interesting when using these types of applications because you can visualize multiple data at the same time. For example, one tab, the customer data, such as their details. A second tab could display the customer order history, and a third tab could include a sales chart. Now let's see how to create and configure this type of application for your own project. So I have already created three different applications: grid orders, chart top region orders, and form 12, which are all available within the samples project, which I will be using for this example. So first of all, let's have a look at these individually. So the grid application, if I run that, we can see that we have a sales grid. And if I run the chart application, you can see that we have a fully functional chart with some sales information. And then running the form application, we have a fully functional form with some relevant data. So let's start by creating the tab application. So I will select new application, and then I will click on the tabs application. I will specify the application name and also the localization. And I can also adjust the theme. When I'm ready, I can click the create button. Once the application is created, it will open on the folder setting, which is where you can create the tabs for your application. So now here, I will want to create three tabs for my three applications. I first need to add a label, and then I'm able to add the tab. Below the label, I can include an image which will be displayed within the tab. At the bottom here, I can specify the minimum and maximum width of each tab. Okay, so I will go ahead and click the add button, creating my first tab, and then continue to add the following two tabs, which are also wanted. Now, when I run the tabbed application, you will see that the three tabs are displayed, but no application are yet available. And also, I have an exit button, which is by default included. To the top, I also have the default header included within the tabbed application. So let's continue and configure the application to be displayed within each tab. So going back to the Scriptcase settings and then selecting application settings. Now within the application settings, I can configure each tab to a relevant application. Selecting a tab, I am then able to add applications below, edit them, as well as remove them. So clicking add will open the application search. So here I can search straight away for the grid orders, select it, click next. I can then specify a width of the iframe as well as the height and wherever I want to reload the content within an iframe. I will continue and click confirm. I will then go ahead and add the second application, which will be then the form. Again, I will select the form, click next. This time I have the iframe width and height as previous, as well as the option to reload. But because it is a form, parameters are usually available. And at this stage, parameters are possible to pass or receive from application to application. Here we are then able to specify the type of parameter when available and indicate a value if required. For this form, I will just go ahead and select the confirm button and add the application to the second tab. I'll select the third tab and this time add the chart. Again, selecting it, clicking next, and then confirm. The chart has now also been added to my application. Now, if I go ahead and run this, we will see now an application available within each tab. Going back to the Scriptcase tab settings, we can see here that there are many options for the placement of the tabs, as well as how they are displayed. For instance, you can change here from the type of tab that you want to have displayed, folder on the top, folder on the bottom, left, right, menu on the top, bottom, left, right, as well as side by side. Selecting one of these, you'll be able to see the slight difference from tabs to menus, as well as then the placement of the tab folders. We also then have the side-by-side option, which will place the applications side-by-side, allowing the display of all tabs at once. Going back to the settings, do note that there are further settings available here. For instance, we can change the measurement unit from percent to pixel, the tab alignment from left, right, and center, the application alignment margins, as well as the position of the exit button. For the exit button, we can place at the bottom of the page, within the folder, the button within the toolbar, or in view. We can also change the exit button to a simple icon by uploading one here. As you can see, the tabbed application can be very useful when wanting to display many types of data to an end user. It is easy to manipulate and adjust. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.